Welcome back to my channel Math School. So in today's video, let us solve the last question, that is question number 11 from exercise 11.1, chapter 11, Introduction to Trigonometry. In my previous videos, I have completed examples 1 to 5 and questions 1 to 10 from the same exercise. If you have not watched these videos, do find the link in the description box below or click the I button above. So now quickly, let us begin with the video. Question number 11 from exercise 11.1, chapter 11, Introduction to Trigonometry says, state whether the following are true or false. Justify your answer. There are 5 parts of the question. We will solve first part first. So the first part of the question is given as, the value of tan A is always less than 1. Here, let us find out whether the value of tan A is always less than 1. So, what is the trigonometric ratio for tan A? As I have told you, to find out any trigonometric ratio, you have to remember this relationship, that is PBP divided by HHB. Here, the first trigonometric ratio, sine, is given by perpendicular by hypotenuse, then base by hypotenuse will be cos, tan will be perpendicular by base, and the opposite of these will be cosecant, secant and cot. So here they have asked us the value of tan. Tan A trigonometric ratio is what? Perpendicular by base. So let first draw a right angle triangle so that you will have a better understanding. So this is a right angle triangle. Now let us assume this angle to be angle A, that is the acute angle. So the side opposite this acute angle will be the perpendicular, side along will be the base, and the side opposite this right angle will be the hypotenuse. Now for example, let us assume this perpendicular to be 12 and base to be 5. So here the tan A value will be 12 by 5. When you divide 12 by 5, what is the result you get? So 5, 2s are 10, 2 is the remainder, put a point here and a 0, 5, 4s are 20. So here we got the value as 2.4, which is greater than 1. And also, if you assume now our acute angle to be this angle, so assuming our acute angle to be here, now our perpendicular will be the opposite of acute angle. So this will be our perpendicular and this will be our base. Now changing our acute angle, again tan A value is was perpendicular by base. So here now perpendicular will be 5 by 12. Now if you divide 5 by 12, so here we will take a point because 12 is less than 5. Adding a 0 here, so 12 4s are 48. So 2 is a remainder. Again adding a 0, 12 1s are 12. Again 8 is a remainder. So this goes on. So here you can see that now we got 0.41, which is less than 1. So here our tan A value can be either greater than 0 or it can be less than 0. So the statement in the part 1 of the question is false. Now let us solve the second part of the question, which says secant A equal to 12 by 5 for some value of angle A. So here they have given us secant A equal to 12 by 5. So again, let us draw a right angle triangle first. So if this is our acute angle, so the side opposite will be the perpendicular, along is the base, and the side opposite the right angle will be our hypotenuse. So what is the trigonometric ratio for secant? Secant is hypotenuse by base. So this is our hypotenuse value, that is 12, and our base value is 5. So hypotenuse is 12 and base value as 5. This is what is given here. Using the Pythagoras theorem, applying the Pythagoras theorem to this triangle, we can find out the value of perpendicular as well. So hypotenuse square is equal to the perpendicular square plus the base square. Here hypotenuse is 12, so it is 12 square. Perpendicular value we have to find out, plus base is 5 square. So 12 square is 144. So send this 5 square to left hand side, we get minus 25 is equal to the perpendicular square. So 144 minus 25 will be, so it is 119 equal to perpendicular square. So here we cannot find out the square root of 119. So p will be square root of 119, which is obviously less than 12 square, right? So here our hypotenuse is the longest side. So therefore, this ratio of secant a equal to 12 by 5 is true, because hypotenuse is the longest side. Now coming to the third part of the question, which says cos a is the abbreviation used for cosecant of angle a. No, this is false, because cos a is the abbreviation for cosine a, right? And cosec a is the abbreviation for cosecant a. So here the third one is also again false. Now coming to the fourth part of the question, cot a is the product of cot and a. No, it is again false, because cot a is a single term and it is not a product of cot and a. So cot a, we are going to assume it to be a single term, because cot a is a single term and it is not a product of cot and a, right? Here cot is a trigonometric ratio and a is the angle. So this is just, cot a is nothing but it is a single term which we are using. It is not product of cot and a. Again, the fifth part of the question is sine theta is equal to 4 by 3 for some angle of theta. Again, this is similar to question number 2. So let us find out fifth one, that is sine theta is equal to 4 by 3. So here, what is the trigonometric ratio for sine? It is perpendicular by hypotenuse, right? So it is perpendicular by hypotenuse. Again, when you apply the Pythagoras theorem here, we can find out the third side, that is the base. So if you assume this angle to be the acute angle, this is a perpendicular, that is 4, and hypotenuse value is the side opposite the right angle, that is given as here 3, and this is our base which we can find out. But here you can observe one thing is always the hypotenuse is the longest side in this right angle triangle, right? But here the hypotenuse is given as 3, which is less than the perpendicular value, that is 4. So therefore this statement is again false, because the hypotenuse is always the longest side. Hypotenuse is longest always. So these are the answers for the question number 11. If you have any further doubts, you can comment me below in the comment section. In my next video, let us learn section 11.3, trigonometric ratios of some specific angles, from chapter 11, introduction to trigonometry. So till then, do like my video, subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to hit the bell button below to get the latest updates of my videos, as I'll be completing the whole syllabus for class 10th SLC NSERT math. And also do watch the related videos of chapter 11, introduction to trigonometry, shown on the screen. Thank you.